Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is my pleasure to meet with you this morning to share with you what we do, where we have been deployed to work. Our ministry, as the program director has said, consists of several institutions. We are called the Department of Performance, Monitoring and Evaluation, as well as Administration. Under our ministry, we have the MDDA, that is the Media Development and Diversity Agency. We have the IMC, commonly known as the International Marketing Council. We have, which is handles the communication of the entirety of government. We have the Department of Performance Monitoring and Evaluation, which deals with the monitoring the functioning of government and improving government performance. Also, we get involved jointly with the Department of Public Service and Administration on the administrative part of what the title of our ministry says. So we handle all those aspects. But for the purpose of today, we are not here to discuss about GCIS or IMC or any other institution. And I forgot the NYDA, the Youth Development Agency, which also falls under our portfolio. We are here to share with you what we do in the Department of Performance Monitoring and Evaluation. Our task is firstly to set up systems in the entirety of government which will help the executive to perform its function properly and to ensure that we have an efficient administration. And secondly, to ensure that that administration responds to the needs of society and the needs of economy, and to provide solutions in areas where there are difficulties and challenges to improve the performance of the state. We are, to some extent, the entry point of citizens if they are not satisfied about the services we then receive from the various institutions in the country. We set ourselves a task in the beginning to set policy, because there was nothing like this before in 2009. And we had to set policies on how we are going to do the job, which we published through Parliament. The President gave us an instruction to develop performance agreements between the President and all of us as ministers, which we did and were signed. We were asked also to develop an operational agreement and sharing of responsibilities between the ministers and deputy ministers, which we did. We then moved on to formulate what we call delivery agreements. Delivery agreements are agreements which are entered into between the various stakeholders who are responsible to deliver a particular outcome or a particular service. And on the basis of that, bring together those stakeholders in what we call a delivery forum. All those things have been done, and we worked on the program of action of all state departments in relation to the outcomes which have been identified. The outcomes which have been at the 12 outcomes arises out of the 5 priorities of the ruling party, which is education, health, fighting crime and corruption, and safe and job creation and rural development. We have since that time moved a long way in ensuring that the state performs, or we are able to know where the challenges are. We provide a quarterly report to Cabinet with regard to the challenges which we face, and we continue to interact with all the stakeholders, departments, provinces, to ensure that what we identify as challenges could be addressed. Since we began the process, we have been able to deliver those reports to Cabinet and also to the various institutions and stakeholders who are working with us. The question which you may ask, I was so much innovative that we came up with a system in such a short space of time. Obviously, there's a body of knowledge in the world and institutions to monitor and evaluate the functioning of any organization. In doing that, we have been cooperating with a number of countries: Mexico, Chile, Brazil, United States of America, Canada, Great Britain, Indonesia, Malaysia, Australia, and quite a number of countries which we interacted with to share knowledge and experience. We focus basically on 4 areas of interest. One is to ensure that we monitor the 12 outcomes. 2 is to monitor and evaluate the performance of individual departments across the state machinery, so that we are able to improve the functioning of the state departments. 3, we deal with monitoring of the frontline service, particularly on departments or institutions which interact with society directly. Our officers go out into the service points, be it hospitals, police station, office or home affairs, and without announcing their presence, collect information as to what is exactly happening so that we're able to intervene when necessary. We are also responsible to manage the hotline of the presidency, receiving all the information and complaints, routing them to the various institutions where we are supposed to attend to it, do follow-ups, and ensure that the citizens get the response thereof. We also, from time to time, tasked by the president or cabinet to coordinate activities which will require a cross-cutting, coordinating mechanism to respond to particular challenges, like when people send information through the Facebook to the presidency about Beggars Dal, about this area, or when the president goes or the deep state president goes to areas to in a monitoring mission, and they come back to us to say, look, we need to coordinate, bring all the stakeholders which are supposed to resolve this problem. In the past year, we had over 15 or 20 of those type of assignments, which comes to us in that way. Who are our partners in this field? Our partners, which we work with, because we can't do it alone, we'll have to work in partnership with other institutions. We work very closely with what we call transversal institutions, which is your Public Service and Administration Department, your Public Service Commission, the Auditor General, and other research institutions in the country, state-owned, the National Treasury, the Department of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs, so that we collate all our information to ensure that we have got consistent information, all of us, and we assist each other in tackling the problems which we face. One may ask why these institutions and not the rest. You'll know that National Treasury is responsible for ensuring that there's proper financial management in state departments. The Department of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs is responsible for supporting provinces and municipalities. The Public Service Commission is responsible for monitoring the performance of the public service. So those type of institutions we deal with from time to time. We are, however, at this stage, looking at the proper model as to how we can coordinate with Parliament in respect of the reports which they generate, or issues which they raise with departments as to how we can deal with it. We have discussed with the Office of the Speaker. There are some ideas which are beginning to channel, because that is a parliamentary issue, it's not ours, so ours will just respond. We had to take that action because portfolio committees, all of them, come to us individually and say, look, come, let's discuss the performance of the department for which we are responsible. So basically, I appear in almost all portfolio committees in Parliament, apart from our own portfolio committee. So it's quite an extensive work which needs to be done, and the very detailed involved sessions which will go through the portfolio committees with regard to that. We are satisfied that at this point in time where we are, we have been able to execute the mandate which have been given to us, and we think the few months which are going to come and the few years which are going to come will be very exciting from our part. With regard to evaluation, we have now developed the evaluation policy which have been submitted to Cabinet and approved. And we will begin to do the evaluation. We have been doing the monitoring. We'll now begin the task of doing evaluation of the various aspects of the state institutions. And we hope when we get to that point, we'll be able to tell you what are the impacts of the various programs or budgets which we take out from time to time is on society and the outcomes which we'd like to see. With those few words, Program Director, I think I'll be honored to be allowed to sit down and respond to questions, if there'll be any anyway.